Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. Let's begin with today's class. But before that, there are some instructions for you all. All students must be attentive during the class. All students must have their required stationery with them. Ask questions after complete explanation. Don't turn on your videos during class. Do the home task properly in your fair copy and take screenshots of all the slides that appear on your screen. So today's topic is translations from Urdu to English. You can see a sentence on your screen, wo gaya, aisa gaya ke gaya hi gaya. Now, if someone tells you to translate the above sentence of Urdu into English, how will it be translated? Wo gaya becomes he went, aisa gaya becomes like went, ke becomes that, and gaya hi gaya becomes went, also went. So is this sentence making any sense? No, a big no, because the translated sentence in English does not have any sense in it at all. Now let's see some Urdu sentences translated into English. Mera dil baag baag ho gaya. If you get this sentence, someone tells you to translate it into English, how will you translate it? My heart became garden garden. If you translate it word to word, it becomes my heart became garden garden. मैंने उसे पढ़ाया. I taught him, her. So this, in the above given example, the sense of the translated sentence is complete and easily understood. Why? Because the sense of the Urdu sentence has been translated into English. And the proper structure of English sentence is used to translate it. You can see that मैंने उसे पढ़ाया. If it is translated word to word, it would be something else. But we have used the proper sense and proper structure of English sentence to translate it into English. For example, I is the subject, taught is the verb, and him or her is the object of the sentence. So the actual structure of an English sentence is subject plus verb plus object. So you have to translate, every time you translate any language into English, you have to place the subject, then the verb, and then the object. The first two sentences of the slide are not giving any sense because they are not giving any sense in reading because those are not translated according to the sense. Instead, those sentences are just translated word to word. Now, let's move forward. There are some points to remember while translating from Urdu to English. Because languages have their own temperament and mode, and as far as we talk about translation, it is never possible to translate the Urdu sentence word to word into English. Firstly, we must comprehend the proper method of translating. You have to identify the tense and you have to remain in the tense. While translating from Urdu to English, you have to remain in the same tense which is given in Urdu sentence. You have to translate the sense, not the words. This point is very important. You have to translate the sense of the sentence and not the actual words. For translating Urdu proverbs into English, first translate those proverbs Urdu to Urdu. For example, wo gaya, aisa gaya ki gaya hi gaya. This is not a proverb. This is just the first example which I am repeating just to give you the sense of Urdu to Urdu. If we translate it into Urdu itself, it becomes wo gaya aur wapas hi nahi aaya. So you have taken out the sense of the sentence, okay? So the sense is wo gaya aur wapas hi nahi aaya. Or you can also say wo hamesha ke liye chala gaya. So the correct translation becomes he went forever. Wo hamesha ke liye chala gaya. Or we can also say he went for good. Here, for good means forever. So whenever in future you need to write this word, you forever, you can also use for good. Translation of direct speech is typical to translate because the rules of narrations are also to be applied while translating narrations from Urdu to English. So you have to be very particular while changing direct speeches in Urdu into translation into English, and you have to make it indirect according to the rules of narration. Urdu sentences which have K and jo K must be dealt very carefully because it need here these sentences need some changes in tenses and pronouns. Now let's learn translations of all 12 tenses of Urdu to English. First, let's review the basic steps to translate Urdu sentences into English, and they are: identify the tense, then identify the subject of the sentence, and then identify the verb or the action verb in the sentence. After the application of the first two steps, that is identifying the tense and identifying the subject and the verb, the remaining part of the sentence or the object of the Urdu sentence is added to the English sentence. Like, we have to follow the structure subject plus verb plus object. So after the application of the first two steps, identify the tense and identify the subject and the verb, the third part, the remaining part of the sentence of the Urdu is added to the English sentence. For example, wo school jati hai. The tense identified is present indefinite, so the translation will be she goes to school. Now let's learn translating all the tenses, and before that there is a chart of pronouns. In nominative cases, for singular, main becomes I, hum becomes we, tum aur aap becomes you, wo ladka becomes he, wo ladki becomes she for singular. If there are more than one wo, it becomes they, and ye and wo, lifeless things, lifeless objects or bejaan, we call it it. In possessive case, mera becomes my, hamara becomes our, tumhara or aapka, it becomes your. Uska is his. Uska for masculine, feminine gender, it becomes her. Unka, it becomes their. And uska, it becomes its. Okay. Now in objective cases, mujhe, hame, tumhe, usse, usse, unhe, and usse. It mujhe becomes me. Hame becomes us. Tumhe becomes you. Usse and usse, it becomes him for masculine and her for feminine. And unhe, if it is a plural, then it becomes them. And usse, it becomes it. Okay, so dear students, we are moving towards the chart of all the tenses. First is simple present. See, you have to follow the structure subject plus the first form of verb plus object. Okay, addition of s and es according to your grammar rules, which have been taught to you during tenses, must be applied here with the first form of verb. For example, hum sham ko khelte hain. We play in the evening. See here, because it is first person plural, we will not add s with the verb. We play in the evening, it will become. Parinde aasman mein udte hain. Birds fly in the air. Okay, if it was singular, you must have added here ies instead of y. Okay, next sentence is mere abbu rozana daftar jaate hain. Now here mere abbu, we are talking about a singular person, so it becomes my father goes. We have added here es after the verb form go. My father goes to office daily. Now let's see the negative sentence. Subject plus do not or does not, then the first form of verb and the object. Urdu sentence is main sham ko nahi khelta, so it becomes I do not play in the evening. Now we are talking about some other person. Wo apni ammi ki baat nahi manta, so it becomes he. Manta we have taken from he, we have taken from the manta. He does not obey his mother. Wo apni ammi means his mother. Okay, so we have added here es after the verb. Now let's see the interrogative sentence. Do or does before the subject. Do is for IU, we, they, and does for he, she, it. Okay, so it will be used before the subject and the first form of the verb will be added. It is not necessary to change. It is not the rule to change the form of verb in the sentence. So, kya wo school jata hai? It becomes does he go to school? Wo school jata hai is translated into he go to school. Why? Because does is playing the role of the verb. So there is no need to add es here because of the second person singular. Does he go to school? Kya wo school jata hai? Kya hum sham ko khelte hain? Do we play in the evening? Here we are talking about plural, so we will use here do. Do we play in the evening? Let's move forward. Past simple affirmative. Past simple affirmative is the most simplest, is the simplest form of structure, because for all the subjects we use the second form of verb. Okay, there is no classification of adding e or s, es, or using the same plain form of verb, or he, she, it, and I, you, we, they. There is no compulsion here for all the subjects we have to use the second form of verb. For example, वो library गया. He went to the library. अम्मी ने खाना पकाया. Mother cooked food. Okay? If it was मैंने खाना बनाया, so you, instead of mother, it becomes I cooked food. There is no foundation of any type of change in the form of verb. For all the subjects, we use second form of verb in translation also. उसने खत नहीं लिखा. He did not write a letter. Because in between subject and the form of first form of verb, we will add did not. There is no need of does not or do not. Okay? Like does not or do not, there is no classification of using any other helping verb instead of did. For all the subjects, you will always use did not in past simple. उसने खत नहीं लिखा. He did not write a letter. वो कराची नहीं गए. See, this गए is giving you the sense of plural. That is why you will write here, they did not visit Karachi. Interrogative is did, then the subject. Okay? Again, it is past simple. There is only one helping verb that is to be used for all the subjects. Did plus subject plus first form of verb plus object. So, the sentence in Urdu is, kya usne kal kaam kiya? Did he work yesterday? Yesterday means जो कल गुजर गया. क्या अम्मी ने खाना पकाया? Did mother cook food? And in interrogative, you always have to put an interrogation mark. If you do not do this, your sentence will be considered incomplete. Now we are talking about future simple affirmative. Subject plus will plus first form of verb and object. Ali kal Lahore jayega. Ali will go to Lahore tomorrow. Like past simple, we also have the same helping verb for future simple for all the subjects. Okay? For all the subjects, you will just use will and the first form of verb, then the object. Ammi sham ko khana pakayengi. Mother will cook food in the evening. Now let's see the negative. Subject plus will not. Again, will not for all the subjects in negative future simple. With the first form of verb plus object. Sentence is, ladke shaam mein football nahi khelenge. We are talking about the future. How we know it? Because it is giving a khelenge and it is a negative sentence. That means, nahi khelenge. Boys will not play. See, we are following the structure will not plus first form of verb. Will not plus first form of verb play. Wo tum aur aap. वो तुमसे बात नहीं करेंगे और यू कैन से वो आपसे बात नहीं करेंगे. सो द सेंटेंस बिकम्स दे विल नॉट टॉक टू यू. करेंगे एंड वो इज गिविंग यू द सेंस ऑफ प्लूरल. सो यू विल यूज हियर प्लूरल दे विल नॉट टॉक टू यू. इंट्रोगेटिव स्ट्रक्चर इज विल प्लस सब्जेक्ट प्लस फर्स्ट फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब प्लस ऑब्जेक्ट. क्या अम्मी खाना पकाएंगी? विल मदर कुक फूड? Will be used for all the subjects. Okay, there is no classification, there is no discrimination of the usage of helping verb in past simple and future simple. Kya ammi khana pakayengi? Will mother cook food? Kya kal wo school jayenge? Will they go to school tomorrow? Now, this is present continuous tense, affirmative. Here, you will use subject with is, am or are. These are the helping verbs used according to the subject. If the subject is he, she, it or any singular noun, you will use is with the first form of verb and ing. First form of verb and ing becomes the present participle. Okay? So you will use is with he, she, it, any singular noun. Am just goes with I and are with the plural subjects like you, we, you singular, you plural, you, we, they goes with are and the first form of verb plus ing, which is also called the present participle. For example, Sara cake bana rahi hai. Okay, so Sara is baking a cake. The action is in process. Bacche baag mein khel rahe hain. Children are playing in the garden. Now let's see negative subject plus is, am, are plus not. Because it is a negative, not will be added between the helping verb, subject helping verb and the present participle of the sentence. Present participle is first form of verb plus ing. Wo khana nahi bana rahi hai. she is not cooking food. Rahi hai is giving here. She is. Ali padhai nahi kar raha hai. Ali is not studying. Interrogative is, am, are comes before the subject, then the present participle, then the object. Kya wo ek kitab pad raha hai? Is he reading a book? Kya main ye theek tarah kar rahi hu? Am I doing it correctly? Next tense is past continuous tense. Affirmative first we'll see. Subject plus was, were plus the present participle. As discussed earlier, present participle is first form of verb plus ing. It becomes present participle and then the object. Parinde aasman mein ud rahe hain. Birds were flying in the sky. Ud rahe the, sorry. Parinde aasman mein ud rahe the. It becomes birds were flying in the sky. The action was continuing in the past. Ammi khana bana rahi thi. Mother was cooking food. Negative past continuous becomes subject plus was not or were not according to the subjects here. Was is used with singular and were is used with you, we, they. Okay. Subject plus was not or were not with the present participle and the object. Ali khana nahi kha raha tha. Ali was not eating his lunch. बच्चे मैच नहीं देख रहे थे. Children were not watching the match. Children were not watching the match. Were is used because the subject is plural here, and here was is used because the subject is singular. The next type of sentence is interrogative of past continuous. For that again the helping verb comes before the subject, then the present participle and then the object. क्या अली अपना खाना खा रहा था? You are asking a question in a continuous form. Okay, so which was happening in the past. Was Ali eating his lunch? Kya bachche match dekh rahe the? Were the children watching the match? Next tense is future continuous tense, and let's see the affirmative type. Subject plus will be plus present participle and the object. Here you will use will be for all types of subjects. I, you, we, they, he, she, it, any singular or any plural noun, you will use will be and then the present participle and then the object. So, Ahmed kal aane wala hai. Ahmed will be coming tomorrow. Wo aapko bulane wale hai. They will be calling you. Negative of future continuous is subject plus will not be. For all the subjects, okay, there is no discrimination of any type of change in the helping verb for any type of subject in future continuous tense. Subject plus will not be plus present participle and the object. Ali film nahi dekhne wala hai. Ali will not be watching the movie. Ammi cake nahi banane wali hai. Mother will not be baking a cake. Now let's see the interrogative. Will plus subject plus present participle plus object. Okay, so will be placed before all the subjects in future continuous tense interrogative type of sentence. If we want to translate, kya kal wo London ke liye ravana hone wale hain, we will place the helping verb, the will, which is asking the question here. Will they be leaving for London tomorrow? Next sentence is, kya main wahan jaane wala hoon? Will I be going there? See, here the subject is they and here the subject is I, but will is used for both the types of subjects. Let's move forward. Next tense is present perfect tense. Let's see the affirmative type of sentence. Subject plus has or have, then the present participle, that is the the past participle, that is the third form of verb, then the object. Now what is the past participle? Past participle is the third form of verb, which is used in all the perfect tenses. Okay, and has is used for he, she, it, and any singular noun, and have is used for I, you, we, they. If the subject is I, you, we, they, we will use have here. Okay, let's see the sentence. Ammi ne khana bana liya hai. Mother has cooked food. Bachcho ne apna kaam mukammal kar liya hai. So the term mukammal will be translated as completed. If here you have khatam kar liya hai, then you will give the term finished here, okay? But here the sentence is बच्चों ने अपना काम मुकम्मल कर लिया है. The sentence translation becomes children have. Here children is the plural form, so we will use here have. Children have completed their work. Now let's see the negative of present perfect tense. Subject plus has not or have not. According to the subject, you will use has not or have not. Then the past participle and the object. बच्चों ने अपना सबक नहीं पढ़ा है. ओके, स्टूडेंट्स हैव नॉट लर्न देयर लेसन. हियर फॉर लर्न्ड एंड लर्न्ड यू कैन यूज बोथ बिकॉज बोथ आर कंसिडर्ड एज पास्ट पार्टिसिपल्स. बच्चों ने अपना सबक नहीं पढ़ा है. स्टूडेंट्स हैव नॉट लर्न्ड देयर लेसन. अम्मी ने खाना नहीं पकाया है. मदर हैज नॉट कुक्ड फूड. See here, पकाया नहीं पकाया है becomes has not cooked. Okay, अब खाना becomes food, but it is the object of the sentence. According to the English structure of sentence, object will be placed at the end. Okay, interrogative of present perfect tense has or have before the subject. It is placed before the subject. That is why it is written with the capital letters. Has the subject, past participle and object, or have subject, past participle and object. So if the Urdu sentence is kya usne apna kaam khatam kar liya hai, the translation will be has he finished the task. क्या तुमने और आपने अपना सबक पढ़ लिया है. हैव यू लर्न योर लेसन. लेट्स मूव फॉरवर्ड. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी पास्ट परफेक्ट टेंस अफर्मेटिव नेगेटिव एंड इंट्रोगेटिव. सो फर्स्ट लेट्स सी द अफर्मेटिव पार्ट. सब्जेक्ट प्लस हैड प्लस पास्ट पार्टिसिपल एंड द ऑब्जेक्ट. लाइक पास्ट सिंपल एंड लाइक फ्यूचर सिंपल पास्ट परफेक्ट टेंस इज ऑल्सो वेरी इजी विद द helping verb point of view, because for all the subjects we just use had here. Okay, so it is the simplest form of sentence and it is very easy to translate these type of sentences. मेरे अंदर आने से पहले वो दरवाजा बंद कर चुकी थी. So there are two parts of the sentence. One is past simple and other is the past perfect. So we will translate it in the same sense. She had shut the door. This is the past perfect part. Before I came in. This is the past simple part. In your examinations, in your board papers, you get these type of sentences usually for translation. So you have to learn properly. You have to practice these type of sentences, which has two parts of tenses in the single sentence. Next sentence is उस्ताद के आने से पहले अली अपना काम मुकम्मल कर चुका था. Ali had completed his work. उस्ताद के आने से पहले. It becomes before the teacher arrived. Okay. But before the teacher arrived, Ali had completed his work. This is the past perfect tense. Now let's see the negative. Subject plus had not, then the past participle and the object. वो बाजार नहीं जा चुकी थी. She had not gone to the market. वो फिल्म नहीं देख चुके थे. They had not watched the movie. Okay, you will place the subject, then the verb, and then the object in all the tenses as explained to you in the first second slides. You have to place the subject according to the structure subject plus verb plus object. Now let's see the interrogative. Had plus all the subjects. For all the subject, you will place had before the subject, then the past participle, and then the object. क्या वो खाना पसंद कर चुके थे. Had they liked the lunch. क्या वो अपने कपड़े खुद सी चुकी थी. Had she stitched the dress herself. Okay, let's move forward. The next tense is future perfect tense and the type of sentence is affirmative. Subject plus will have. Again, there is no change in the helping verb. For all the subjects, we will use will have. For future perfect tense, will have, then the past participle, and then the object. मैं कल तक अपना काम मुकम्मल कर चुका हूँगा. I will have completed my assignment by tomorrow. वो 2 बजे तक अपना खाना खा चुके होंगे. तक for तक या कल तक अपना काम मुकम्मल कर चुका होगा और वो 2 बजे तक अपना काम खाना खा चुके होंगे. सो वी विल यूज बाय फॉर द स्ट्रक्चर. दे विल हैव ईटन देयर फूड बाय 2 o'clock. ओके, व्हेनेवर देयर इज स्टक इन उर्दू सेंटेंस इट बिकम्स बाय इन इंग्लिश ट्रांसलेशन. फॉर नेगेटिव फ्यूचर परफेक्ट टेंस यू यूज सब्जेक्ट plus will not have. You will place negative not between the subject helping verb and have, and then the past participle and then the object. वो 2 बजे तक अपना खाना नहीं खा चुके होंगे. They will not have eaten their food by 2 o'clock. Next sentence, मैं कल तक अपना काम मुकम्मल नहीं कर चुका हूंगा. I will not have completed my assignment by tomorrow. Now let's see the interrogative. Will plus subject plus have. Here the helping verb will be placed before the subject like all the interrogative sentences. All the types of interrogative sentences we use helping verbs before the subjects to give it a interrogative form. Will plus subject plus have. Then present participle and object. The sentence is, क्या वो क्रिकेट खेल चुका होगा? Will he have played cricket? Now see he and I, both are the different subjects, but we are using here have according to the structure of interrogative of future perfect tense. Okay, there is no has used in future perfect. क्या मैं खत लिख चुका होगा? Will I have written a letter? Now we are moving towards the perfect continuous tenses, and the first is present perfect continuous tense. Let's see the affirmative type of present perfect continuous tense. It is subject plus has been or have been with the present participle. Again, the present participle is first form of verb plus ing because it is present and continuous, and for giving the perfect sense we are using here has and have been. Let's see the Urdu sentence. मैं इस कंपनी में 5 साल से काम कर रहा हूँ. I have been working in this company for 5 years. Okay, 5 साल से के लिए we are using for 5 years because we don't know the exact time period, exact point of time. So we are using here for 5 years. If we know the exact if it had been given here, मैं इस कंपनी में 5 साल से काम कर रहा हूँ. Instead of 5 साल, if it was 2015, so we will say, we will translate it as I have been working in this company since 2015. Okay, so if there is the actual point of time, we will use since, and if there is a period, a duration of time, we will use for in the present perfect continuous tense. Let's see the next sentence. वो इस स्कूल में 1990 से पढ़ा रही है. So the translation becomes she has been teaching in the school since 1990. See, this is the exact starting point of time. So since is used here. Now let's see the negative. Subject plus has not been or have not been with the present participle and then the object. वो पिछले हफ्ते से उससे बात नहीं कर रही है. हफ्ते से means this is the time reference. Okay, for and since is used according to, for is used for period of time and since is used for exact point of time with the time reference. Okay, so वो पिछले हफ्ते से उससे बात नहीं कर रही है. She has not been talking to her since last week. Here last week is the exact point of time which we know, so we are using here since last week. वो कई सालों से पाकिस्तान नहीं आ रहे हैं. See here we don't know the time period. This we don't know the exact point of time. We just know the time period. कई सालों से. So we are using here for many years. They have not been visiting Pakistan for many years. Now the interrogative. Have or has with the subject, according to the subject, then been, then the present participle and the object. क्या वो यहाँ 2002 से काम कर रहा है? Has he been working here since 2002? See, this is the exact point of time, that is why since is used here. क्या तुम 2 घंटों से सबक ज़बानी याद कर रहे हो? Have you been learning the lesson by heart for 2 hours? This is a time period, so 4 is used here. Now we are talking about past perfect continuous tense. Affirmative type, subject had been, then the present participle, then the object, then you will add since or for according to the given time and then the time reference. Wo bachpan se dibbe se doodh pee raha tha. So it becomes he had been drinking milk from the carton since he was a child. You are talking about a time that started in the verb that started in the past, it continued in the past and ended in the past. That becomes your past perfect continuous tense. So it is here, the time frame is since he was a child. Wo bachpan se. Bachpan se, so he is taking the wo is taking the place of subject of the sentence, so it becomes the first part of the sentence. Then had been drinking milk. Dabbe se doodh pee raha tha. Se is the time fraction, so we are using here since he was a child because the exact point of his age is given here. Since he was a child. Bacche do ghanton se khel rahe the. This do ghanton se is the time period. Okay, this is not the exact starting point of the time, so we are using here children had been playing for 2 hours. Now let's see the negative type of past perfect continuous tense. Subject plus had not been. Okay, here again had is only used. There is no need of has changing the helping verb like has or have. Then the present participle and then the object. For example, नौकरानी ईमानदाराना तौर पर काम नहीं कर रही थी जब उसे मुलाजिम रखा गया था. जब से is the time period. Okay, this is the exact point. जब से उसे मुलाजिम रखा गया था. So the translation becomes the maid had not been working honestly since she was hired. See, this is the exact point of time. So we will use since here. Okay. Main 3 ghante se mazmoon likh raha tha. I had been writing an article for 3 hours. This 3 ghante se is the time period. So 4 will be used before 3 hours. Then the interrogative has the had, then the subject, then been, object, and then the since and for, and then the time reference, like affirmative and negative. Kya Ali subah se wo kitab pad raha tha? Had Ali been reading that book since morning? This is the exact point of time. See, so since is used here. Kya aap 2 din se apne khat ki talash kar rahe the? Had you been searching for your letter for 2 days? Okay, some students get confused and they write finding here. Talash and find is something different. Talash is search and dhoona or paana is find. Okay, so please be sure about using certain words. Now we are moving towards the future perfect continuous tense affirmative type. Subject will have been, present participle, then the object, then since, for, and then the time reference. So the sentence of Urdu is, wo 1988 se isi makan mein reh rahe honge. So this is, they are talking about the future. They will have been living in the same house since 1988. Wo subha savere se hi eid ke liye khana bana rahi hogi. Okay, they are talking about an action which is going to start in the future and it is going to continue in the future. So the sentence will be translated as she will have been cooking food for Eid since early morning. Now let's see towards the negative. Subject will not have been plus present participle, then the object, then the time reference with since and for. Wo subah se hockey nahi khel rahe honge. They will not have been playing hockey since morning because subah se. In Urdu sentence the word is given subah se. मैं दो घंटों से मुताला नहीं कर रहा हूंगा. आई शैल नॉट हैव बीन स्टडीइंग फॉर 2 hours. ओके, नाउ लेट्स सी द इंट्रोगेटिव पार्ट. शैल और विल, देन द सब्जेक्ट, देन हैव बीन, देन द प्रेजेंट पार्टिसिपल, देन द ऑब्जेक्ट विद सिंस फॉर एंड द टाइम रेफरेंस. क्या वो 2 घंटों से खेल रहे होंगे? विल दे हैव बीन प्लेइंग फॉर 2 hours? see here again the subject as we have singular subject and plural subject, but because of the structure will be used with both the subjects. Kya wo 2 ghanton se khel rahe honge? Will they have been playing for 2 hours? And kya tum kal se darwaze ko rang kar rahe hoge? Will you have been painting the door since yesterday? Now dear students, that was about all the 12 tenses with all the affirmative, negative and interrogative parts. So I hope you all have understood. So let's move forward. Also have sentences with some modal verbs in them. Okay, so if we get such type of sentences, these are called modal verbs. Can, could, may, might, should, must, would, dare, need. These are called modal verbs which show different types of abilities and different types of modes of speaking. So if the sentence is giving the sense ho sakta hai, so may will be used. Kar sakta tha, could. Kar sakta hai, it is showing the ability. Zarur karna hai, so must will be used. So must is giving the compulsion. करना चाहिए should. Should is given used as a suggestion. करना चाहिए. हो सकता था might be possible. Okay, which could be possible in the past. Okay, जरूरत होना means need. जरूरत होना means to dare. करेगा means would. Now these are some sentences examples with modal verbs and translation. क्या तुम मेरी मदद कर सकती हो? So this sentence is asking about some ability. So can is used here. Can you help me? क्या शाम को हम चाय पी सकते हैं? Can we have tea in the evening? Third sentence is आपको नमाज नहीं छोड़नी चाहिए. नहीं छोड़नी चाहिए means this is a suggestion type of sentence. So you should not skip prayers. Fourth sentence is आपको बड़ों से बदतमीजी नहीं करनी चाहिए. You should not insult adults. आपको थोड़ा एहसास करना चाहिए. You should realize a little. शायद वो आपसे मिलने आए. See here it is a possibility. शायद. So may is used here. She may come to see you. Next sentence is शायद आज बारिश हो जाए. So for शायद may is used here. It may rain today. हो सकता है उसकी तबीयत ठीक ना हो. He may not be well. Next, क्या आप कॉफी पीना पसंद करेंगी? Would you like to drink coffee? So here would is asked as पसंद और ना पसंद. Okay? For the tenth sentence, क्या आप मुझे दोबारा वजाहत करेंगी? Would you explain me again? Okay, dear students, in your examinations, you also get some translations of proverbs. Urdu proverbs are given and you have to translate those into English. But again, you don't have to translate them word to word. You have to find out the sense of the sentence, of the Urdu sentence, of the proverb, and then you have to translate it into English. Jise Allah rakhe, use kaun chakhe. If Allah wills not, no one can harm. So these are the sentences. Okay, let's move towards the home task. So dear students, these are the two slides of your home task. You have to translate these sentences into English. Please take a screenshot of these slides. And I hope you have taken the screenshots of all the previous slides as instructed before. And this is the second slide, which you have to translate into English. Okay, so dear students, take care, stay home, stay safe. Allah Hafiz.